Assalamu alaikum, guys. So at the moment we're traveling through the South Island, and I thought I'd do a little video on whether Muslims can travel in New Zealand, and if they were to travel, like the things you'd think about and whether they are available or not. So one of the things when it comes to mind when traveling overseas is there halal food? So in New Zealand, alhamdulillah, there's a lot of halal options. So especially up north, there's like every major city you go to has halal options. And then as you head to the South Island, you've got like the bigger cities and you've got smaller cities. They've also got halal options as well. But the thing is, you have to have like a supermarket nearby to kind of get those food options. And your last resort is always going to be kebabs, which majority of the places you go to do actually have. And we were just up in a place that's like in the middle of nowhere, Hanmer Springs, which is actually a bit of a drive, and they had halal food there, and it was Jordanian food as well, which ended up being better than a lot of the other food that I have actually tried in Auckland as well. It's almost like how it was back in Jordan. So there's so many different options, and everywhere you go there's always going to be like halal food. And if not, in New Zealand as well, one good thing that's kind of, I guess, trending at the moment is vegan options. So we are very vegan friendly. So the options are growing, and regardless, if you can't get meat options, you can always get the plant-based foods and always get those options as well. The second thing on your mind probably is there a place to pray? Is there a masjid? So once again, in North Island, majority of the major cities have so many different masjids, so many different Islamic centers. You have like a lot of places to pray. But as you come to the South Island, it's the major cities have masjids as well. But the thing is, as you go to these smaller towns, they don't have the places to pray. But some of them have small Islamic centers. But once again, these are like the kind of smaller cities. But where we are right now, there isn't any Islamic center. But the thing is, you can always pray out and about. So yesterday where we were praying was through Arthur's Pass. Like the view was amazing. There was fresh water coming straight from the mountain. We did our wudu there, and we were able to do salat on the side. The cool thing in New Zealand as well is, which you don't find overseas too much, is there's public toilets on every stop as well. So every major stop you have along the route has the public toilet. So you can do your wudu, you can get ready for salat there as well. So those are the things that were on my mind when coming down to South Island. Because in North Island where we live, it's a lot easier because we know where the masjids are, we know what food is best. And coming down to South Island, those were things on my mind. And yeah, alhamdulillah, we were able to do this 5-day trip with no issues whatsoever. And New Zealand people are very friendly as well, so you will experience that. Especially in the North Island, you'll experience a lot more friendliness. South Island is really great as well. People are friendly. But since I'm from North Island, I'm just a little bit biased, but yeah. So alhamdulillah, this is a really good trip. If you have any questions about New Zealand or, you know, how it is, and any cities you might be coming to, feel free to just drop a question in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video and it was informative, just give it a big thumbs up and subscribe for my other videos as well. And inshallah, I'll catch you guys up in the next one. Assalamu alaikum.